On that note, let's bring in our next guest on the show. Ashish Puravankara, MD Puravankara, joins us. Now, recently, Shobha, of course, reported some very strong pre-sales numbers. So, Ashish, we thought we'll run it past you and figure out if the trend is really holding for Bengaluru as a whole. So, the market focus for your company is also Bangalore. Can we expect similar growth numbers from Puravankara?
So, the last quarter sales have been good. They've been very encouraging. We launched a project in Bangalore under the Provident brand, where we saw really good sales. The trend seems good and positive.
Okay. So that's Bangalore. What about other markets? How have they done in Q4?
Yes. So we're currently present in Pune, which is doing well. Hyderabad for us is doing well. We just started a pre-launch in Goa, which is quite encouraging. The Bangalore launch did extremely well.
Okay, Ashish, recently reports had suggested there has been a downtick in prices in Pune, in Bangalore, and even in the Mumbai region. We were told that Ahmedabad and Hyderabad have witnessed uptick in prices. Also, that there may be some softness in the IT businesses in the coming quarters. Your views on all these markets?
So our experience is quite the contrary. So if the recent launch that we did in Bangalore, if you take that as an example, it's done extremely well. We've got good pricing as well. So I think it's one needs to really look at which city, which micro market within that city. I strongly believe that a good brand, a well-priced product will see good sales.
Okay, so what's the pipeline looking like? Sales volume grew by 31% in Q3. Affordable segment was about 44%. What's the guidance?
So we don't give guidance on annual sales numbers, but in terms of launches, the success of these launches, we're quite excited. So we have about 15 million, like we mentioned last quarter, of launches, 10 million under the Provident brand, around 5 million under the Puravankara brand. Out of the 10 million under the Provident, we have already launched 2 million in Bangalore, which has done well. We have we've just started a pre-launch of another 1.9 million square foot in Goa, which is looking good so far. So we're quite excited. We have an additional 6 million of launches for the year under Provident and 5 under Puravankara.
Okay, that's interesting. So a lot of new launches coming up. Two more parameters, Ashish. What is the unsold inventory level at your end? And also current debt position with any reduction targets if you have them?
So in terms of debt today, we've been able to even bring the cost of debt down by another 100 points. So we are currently sitting at 10.67%. Debt would come down on account of internal accruals, especially sales of the ready-to-move in inventory. So there's hardly any money to be spent against those. And every sale and accrual out of that bucket goes towards reducing the debt number. In terms of ready-to-move in inventory, we have seen over the last 2-3 quarters, the sales have picked up. So they're almost 45 to 50% of our quarterly sales have been contributed by the ready-to-move in inventory. So that's quite positive and encouraging.
Okay, just stay on them. Looking quite interesting. Let's move back to Puravankara. Sir, can you quantify the value of the ready-to-move in inventory?
So currently, if you see the approximate value of the ready-to-move inventory, which is completely ready, would be in the range of about 600 to 700 crores across projects and across the cities that we are present in.
Okay, and finally, Ashish, what kind of sales are you expecting from the affordable housing space in FY19? Also, any revenue contribution, average realizations that you are expecting in the next year?
So on the per square foot realization, we should see the Provident realization go up by at least another 7 to 10% over the next 2-3 quarters because of the new launches that we've had. In terms of contribution, I think the percentage, just because of the sheer volume of Provident vis-a-vis Puravankara, and if you look at a blended average, I think Provident sales should account for at least about 40 to 45%.
Okay, Ashish, we leave it there. Thanks a lot for your time today. I tell you something.